Hey Matt 31, I wanted to show you section 3.1, number 81. So we can see the directions here. It says for the following exercises, graph y equals x cubed on this certain viewing window, and then figure out the range for the viewing window. So there's a couple of ways you can interpret this. So let me go over both ways of interpreting it. The first thing I want to do though is graph y equals x cubed. So let me go ahead and do that. Now on my window, I have a fun window from wherever I left off. So if you take a look at this, it says go from negative 100 to 100. And it didn't really specify if these were to be the x values or the y values. So let me interpret them right now as just the x values. So I'll go negative 100 to 100 on the x. And instead of making a tick mark every 1 unit, I don't want 200 tick marks. And I say 200 because you'd have 100 on the left side and 100 on the right side. I'll say just make a tick mark every 10 units. And for right now, I'm gonna pretend that this was only going from negative 10 to 10. If you had hit zoom 6, that would have been the range that would have popped up on the y's. I must have been graphing something in my stats class. That's why my window is so weird. So let's say we interpreted this problem as just setting the x's from negative 100 to 100. And let me go ahead and hit graph, and we'll see part of that graph, right? I really can't see a whole bunch of it. You can barely see it in here. And the reason is we can't see the y's, they're too tall. And if you wanna figure out what the y values are, let's actually plug in negative 100 and cube it. All right, so if I cube it, you see I'm at, ooh, how many is that? It looks like negative 1 million. All right, so let me go back to my graph and we'll talk about this. So if I'm taking a look at this right now, you can see my x's go from negative 100 to 100, but it's barely showing me any graph. So let me adjust my window and make these, I think we said it was negative 1 million, so negative 1, and then I think I need 6 zeros. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then let me make this positive 1 million. And the reason it would be positive 1 million is because if I took one positive 100 and I cubed it, I would get positive 1 million. Let me just count one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, okay. So let me go back to my window and change this to positive 1 million. I'm going to count to 6 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I don't want to scale every 1 unit. I barely want any in there. So I'll make a tick mark every 100,000 units. That requires 5 zeros. All right, let me hit graph. And we're going to see a much better looking graph at this point. So if you interpret the problem in this way, and when I say interpret it in this way, if you just set your x's from negative 100 to 100, then your y's will go from negative 1 million up to positive 1 million. All right, so that's one way to interpret the problem. Another way to interpret it is to say, hey, I just want to set both of these from negative 100 to 100. And you could do that too. All right, and let me, I'll set this at 10. And then you get a much more scrunched cubic function. So if you interpret it this way, then the range is negative 100 to 100 because that's the window you set. So it depends on how you interpret it. I have a feeling they intended this to be the X window or the X min and X max. And then from there you get the Y min and Y max. But you could interpret it either way because it wasn't super specific. But that's how we would do that problem. All right. Thanks so much, gang. Bye.